The mothers were desperate. They were desperate. They had $5,000 debts in a place where people live on $1 a day. They earn $1 a day. So their choice was to make a sacrifice of one child for the better of the family. You know, we're trying not to judge. We're trying to figure out solutions. Obviously, as a mom, these things are so heinous to imagine that a person could decide to have their child be a workhorse in that way to save the family economically, but we are not in their situation.
That's the question,
so we
Mira.
Can't judge.
I mean, did the mothers, you spoke to three parents, did they know what sort of life
they were
sending their children into?
They all knew. They all knew. In some situations, mothers sell their daughters or their sons into a trafficking situation, and they're being defrauded. They're being told that their child is going to work as a nanny or an au pair, or, you know, or a teacher or a waitress, and then they get to another city, and then they're put into a brothel. In this situation, it's a neighborhood broker who comes to broker a deal for the daughter's virginity. It's become an endemic cultural situation in response to a terrible, dire poverty. But, you know, as some people will argue, not all poor people sell their children. So, you know, there's many levels to this issue, you know.
I want to ask you at a personal level. I mean, you have been an activist. You've been in the fight against modern day slavery for years now. So you would be better prepared than many to confront what you saw in Cambodia. But how was it for you as a mother, as someone who's trying to make a difference?
You know what? You can confront it with the issues. I was ready to confront it with issues and with arguments and with ideas. But I was very afraid before I started, because I knew what I was going to get into emotionally, and it was exactly what I feared. You know, it's so dark. It's so dark when you look into the eyes of a child who has been raped and beaten and abused by adults who know her age, who know she's a little girl, and take pleasure in her exploitation and degradation and, you know, the destruction of her soul, the destruction of her future. I mean, as a mother, I find it odious and revolting, and you know, you look at them and you just die for them. And the worst feeling is, okay, now my heart is breaking for this child who's talking to me right now, but she's the lucky one because she has been rescued. She has been found by Don Brewster. She has been brought in by Somali mom. She's in a safe place now, and she has a future now. She's getting an education, she's getting job skills, and she's got a lot of love and support around her. And even her family is coming around that it was the wrong thing to do. What I'm concerned with is the fact that not 40 feet away from us in Swai Pak are rooms in which little children are being raped repeatedly all day long, and that is their life and that is their existence.